So it's 2020 and everything is canceled. You're stuck with that one roommate that you're like, I'm never gonna see this person. So what do? Board games, of course. Hey everybody, what is up? My name is Mackenzie.
And I'm Jonathan.
We are husband and wife, and together we are Teradice Games.
And today we're gonna be talking to you about our top 10 favorite board games for couples. And now, your first mission. Codenames Duet, by the original creators of Codenames. This is a version of Codenames for two players where you're spies trying to communicate through code. Each round, you'll take turns coming up with a word that describes one or multiple agents that you're trying to contact. You have a chance of hitting innocent bystanders if you were to guess wrong, but you really don't want to go after those assassins or it's game over. Next up, we have Splendor, the gem trading game published by Asmodee Games and Space Cowboys.
Now, this game is not new to the world, but it is new to us, and it is one of my favorite new games. I mean, who doesn't love collecting gems, right? Splendor is a simple engine building game with no reading and a few numbers. You are essentially trying to collect the most gems and buy up different cards with those gems, and maybe attract the attention of a noble. Ooh. First person to get 15 points wins.
In this game, you're fighting for a few resources. There's the various gems as well as the cards on the board. And in a four-player game, those things are trading around a lot. But in a two-player game, you have to do a little bit more strategizing, and you end up in a situation where the other player could have a lot of the gems or the other player could have a lot of the cards that you're needing. But I think it makes for a really good challenge, and I think this game works really well two-player.
All right, next on our list, we have super fun game Carcassonne. Now, this game is so great for people that are casual board game players or for people that are just starting to get into board games. Super fun, super easy to pick up on. Game's rules can be taught in about 3 minutes or less.
In this game, you're in the French town of Carcassonne, and you're building out land. In this land, you have highwaymen, and you have knights, and you're trying to take over roads and castles as they expand. The whole purpose of the game is to collect the most points by controlling the most lands. When you complete towns and roads, you remove your meeples from those locations, and you gain points equal to the length or the size of those cities.
You know, one thing I really love about this game is that every time you play, it's gonna look so different. All the different maps, how your river forms, the different villages and castles you make, and the different formations that the map takes. I just think that's really cool.
Next up is Tiny Epic Galaxies from the Tiny Epic series by Gamelin Games.
This game is so great because it is essentially a big game that packs a lot of punch in a tiny, tiny little box. Cute this thing is. This game is great for travel and great for just sticking it in your back pocket on the way to work or maybe like your backpack because that sounds like it might fall out. In my opinion, I would say this is the best game out of the Tiny Epic series. What would you think?
Definitely, I would say so. The game is built really well. It has the right number of components. The components are gorgeous. You have these little wooden meeple rockets and then you've also got these beautiful cards with just really nice texture on them.
And then one thing I really like about this game is that there are so many cards of the different planets you'll be visiting. So what would you say? You only see about 5% of planets a game, so yeah. It has so much replayability.
And that is Tiny Epic Galaxies. Next up on our list is Sherlock Holmes Consulting Detective.
So this game, nice accent by the way.
Oh, thank you.
In this game, you are trying to solve 1 out of 10 crimes that has been assigned to Sherlock Holmes, and you are trying to do it faster than he is.
What makes this a special addition to our list is it's not really a board game. You've got a map, you've got a newspaper, you've got a journal of your own that you've started to write and make notes in, and you've got an interview book and a phone book, and really you're just trying to make connections and try to find your way to solve the crimes.
You will think that you'll have found the answer, and the answer is so crazy, you're like, that can't possibly be it, that doesn't make sense. But then it does make sense, and then you finally read it, and you're like, oh my gosh, that was it! Anyway, I think this game is so much fun and super great for a couple.
Next up on our list is Seven Wonders Duel, the two-player take on Seven Wonders, produced by Antoine Bauza and Bruno Catala, published by Repos Production. It's a two-player game where you're racing to make the most successful empire. You do this by building up resources and getting new resources as the game goes on. The structure is interesting. You have cards placed in a sort of pyramid at the beginning of the game where you can see some cards, you can't see others. And the idea is that as the game goes on, you pick the cards that are available based on the cards that are not overlapping any other cards. There are three ways to win the game. You can either win by pure points through all the cards that you've built into your empire, or you can win by scientific discovery, producing 6 science symbols.
Another way to win Seven Wonders Duel is through war. You gain war points by getting different cards throughout the game, and you move your little token along the board until you reach victory.
We really like playing this game because every time we play it has been pretty different. There's multiple ways to win, there's a lot of different cards, and every game a few cards are left out and the structure changes.
And I also really enjoy this game because it's not just because I happen to win it a lot, but seriously, this game is super awesome. The card art is fantastic, the engine building is phenomenal, and we just have a super great time playing it.
Next up is Hive Pocket by John Yanni. This is an abstract strategy chess-like game that features bugs on hex tiles. The game has no board, so every time you play, the shape's a little bit different. You're trying to connect and move your pieces so that you can surround the enemy queen bee with either your color or their color.
One thing that I really love about this game is that this game is Hive Pocket, which it comes from a bigger version which you can get, which is just Hive. Hive Pocket is so great because it is so cute and tiny and compact, fits in a backpack, and works really great for travel. By Prospero Hall, Villainous is one of my favorite games of all time. It is essentially a classy adult Disney board game. If you love Disney and like board games at all, you will love this game. You take on the role as one of the villains and you are trying to complete the objective, which usually involves defeating a hero before the other villains do. The game can be played up to 6, but plays really well with 2 people.
What we have in front of us is the original Villainous, since there have been 3 expansions, and also a Marvel Villainous. And while we're counting this as one game, what's great is the 3 expansions can be played individually or mixed together, which gives you a chance to mix all those villains and fight them all out to see who would come up on top. And next up on our list is the 1-4 player game, Everdell, designed by James A. Wilson.
Jonathan, you can't do that. That's Rodney Smith's thing.
All right, fine. Everdell!
That was a little over the top, but we'll work on it.
Everdell, Everdell, Everdell. This game is beautiful. This is some of the most beautiful artwork I have ever seen. It gives you resources, it gives you twigs and berries and pebble and resin, and you're collecting those resources, trying to store up for the following winter. You go through spring and fall and summer, and there's this great ever tree in the middle of the board where you would slowly get workers as they emerge from their slumber.
And during the game, you collect little berries, these cute little pebbles, resin, and twigs.
You just feel wholesome playing this game. I mean, look at this barge toad. Look at that guy. Next up on our list is Gloomhaven, the 20-plus-pound game by Cephalofair Games, where you are a mercenary from the town of Gloomhaven, out and about, just running missions and beating up bad guys, and then eventually you may see there's more to the story and you may get involved in a bigger mission. This game is not for the faint of heart. Now, we were pretty new to playing lots of board games when we started this, and the first round that we played took 4 hours, and I was crying trying to read the manual. I had pre-read all 52 pages, and I was still sitting there thinking, oh my goodness, I don't remember any of this. But fortunately, after a few rounds, we've gotten it down to about an hour each time we play.
Each character that you play will have a retirement goal, and once you complete that goal, you get to change onto a new character. So the game just keeps refreshing, and it keeps building and growing, and I think that's what I like the most about it.
Right, and it's definitely the priciest game in our list, but it's certainly worth it. The replayability of this game is just incredible.
How many hours does it say the game ends up taking to complete?
Somewhere around 100 hours. But in the last couple months, they've actually come out with Gloomhaven, Jaws of the Lion, a much more consumable, smaller version of this game. It's an intro story.
Now this game is super great because it has the same jam-packed fun adventure that you're gonna play in Gloomhaven, but it starts with a tutorial, which makes it a lot easier to grasp what exactly is going on in this game. This game has truly proven to me that what an adventure you can have within a board game. All right, folks, and there you have it, our top 10 best board games for couples. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to like and subscribe. I'll make sure to put links down below on where you can get these amazing games, but please also don't forget to visit your friendly local game store.
And if there's any games that you feel that we've missed on this list, please feel free to share them. I'm looking for every excuse possible to convince Mackenzie that we need to buy another game.
Hey, but if we do that, we can make another video. All right, thanks for watching.